Welcome to another edition of Toolbox Tuesday. Normally we kind of feature tools, but today we just kind of want to look at the equipment and talk about something on the heating side that we refer to in the industry as the sequence of operation for a gas-fired furnace. The sequence of operation for a gas-fired furnace is an essential piece in the diagnostics of any furnace. And so it is important for the technician to know the sequence of operations and the steps to follow so that you can ensure that the furnace is firing properly. So we just want to focus on just the steps inside of the sequence. We're going to start our furnace up. We're going to watch that sequence take place and then go from there. So the very first thing that'll happen is we'll get a call from heat from our thermostat. We'll set the thermostat to the desired temperature, and then the thermostat will communicate to the system, letting it know to come on. The next thing that'll happen is our inducer draft motor will begin to spin to cause a draft. Shortly after the inducer draft motor, our pressure switch is gonna prove that our inducer fan motor is working. Shortly after that, we'll see a glow from our hot surface igniter. After that, the gas valve will open, and then we'll hear that whoosh and get that flame that we see in there. On the other end of the hot surface igniter, we're gonna have our flame sensor, which is gonna prove to us that we have a flame, letting the system know that everything is okay. And then finally, our blower motor is gonna kick on once we have that heat inside of our heat exchanger and push that heat through the house, thus satisfying our customer. And then finally, once our thermostat reaches set temperature, the whole system will set off until it is time for it to come on again. So we'll kind of watch that happen as we go through here. So first thing we'll do is we'll raise our temperature up some. Turn our system to heat. Raise our temperature up, make sure our gas is on. So there's our inducer motor. Our inducer motor starts. Once our inducer motor starts, our pressure switch is gonna say, okay, my inducer motor's running, I'm good to go. There's no cracks or leaks anywhere. And then shortly after that, we're gonna get a glow inside our burner housing down here from our hot surface igniter. We'll see that. I can stand back to the side, I see it starting to glow. Next you'll hear a click from the gas valve, and then we'll get a flame. All right, our burners have ignited, we have ignition. Our flame sensor is there on the opposite end to prove that we've got a flame, and it's gonna send the signal to the board, let them know that, hey, everything's working, and now we need to go ahead and turn our blower on and start to send the air through the rest of the household. So in just a second here, we'll hear our blower motor kick on. And our blower motor has kicked on and started to run. And so that's the complete sequence of operation for a gas fire furnace. First, the call for heat, our inducer motor, the pressure switch, our hot surface igniter glows, our gas valve opens, our flame sensor proves flame, our blower motor engages, and then we reach our set temperature. Now I've got it set for 87. We're not gonna wait that long because it's gonna be too hot in here by that time. So we're gonna go ahead and shut it off manually, and then the whole system will shut down and we'll go back on, and the thermostat will wait for the homeowner to give it another cue and set a temperature for it to come on. But that's the sequence of operations for a gas-fired furnace. Thanks for tuning in to another Toolbox Tuesday.